DC. I'm Adam.
And I'm Gracie.
And today is Wednesday, November 20th, and here's the news. Attention seniors, please check your email for a prom theme voting message. Please make your choice for the 2020 prom by this Friday.
Attention students, the DC Media Center will waive an overdue fines for students who bring in canned food goods Thursday and Friday. November 21st and 22nd, all canned goods donated will support the Key Club food drive. Check your school email for information about fines you might owe.
Attention DCHS, this week is the annual canned food drive. These items will help to feed the families of students in need over Thanksgiving. This will be a class competition to earn early release on November 26th prior to Thanksgiving break. Items will be collected in the lobby, so look for the container with your grade on it. Items that are greatly in need are canned green beans, canned corn, instant potatoes, macaroni and cheese, stuffing mix, Jell-O, canned fruit, gravy, cranberry sauce, cereal, chicken broth, Bisquick, toothbrushes, toothpaste, deodorant, soap, paper towels, paper plates, toilet paper, baggies, and Reynolds Wrap.
Okay, Davis County, the canned food drop ends Friday, and we're running really low, so y'all need to bring in stuff.
Attention juniors, the Washington Youth Tour is a six-day, all-expense paid trip to Washington, D.C. Kennergy sends three students from its service territory each summer. The student must be a high school junior with at least a 3.0 overall GPA, and the primary residence must receive electricity from Kennergy. Applications are available in guidance and are due December 31st, 2019.
Now stay tuned for this week's edition of With It Wednesday.
Welcome back to another episode of With It Wednesday. I'm Preston Smith, and I'm joined by
Trevor Garrison, student teacher at Davis County.
So, what's your background? Where are you from?
I'm actually from Hancock County, the little gas station town a couple miles that way, so not too far away.
So, what brought you to Owensboro?
I'm here to student teach, and right off the bat, they asked me where I wanted to apply to student teach, and Davis County was number one on my list.
So. Really?
Yes, sir.
So, do you have any hobbies? What do you do in your free time?
I don't have too much free time, but with my free time, I usually like to coach football. I coach at Hancock County still at the moment, so I love football. It's a big passion of mine, and then when I'm not working or coaching or teaching, I'm watching some football on Sundays.
So who got you into football?
My dad did. I actually started playing when I was 5 years old, and my last year of football was 21 years old at Campbellsville University, so I played for, you know, a solid, what's the math on that, 16 years, I think, so it wasn't bad.
That's impressive.
Good. Yeah, yeah.
So do you have any pets?
I do have a pet. I have a dog. It's a Shih Tzu, Chihuahua, a lot of other stuff. It's really a mutt, but his name's Bob.
So what would you be doing if you weren't in this position?
Really, I sunk all my eggs into the education basket. So I'm glad that this is panning out so far, but if it was not, I flirted with the idea of being a nurse for a little bit or going into something with the medical field, but I couldn't handle blood and all that stuff, so I decided to stick to my guns and be a teacher.
So what pushed you towards the teaching field?
I really love helping kids. That's really why I feel like every good teacher is in the education field, is to help kids, and that's just something that I take in everything as far as coaching, teaching. I really love working with kids and making them hopefully a positive impact.
That really is amazing.
Yeah, it's a rewarding field. It's a very rewarding field.
So is there anything that not many students know about you?
Well, being a social studies major, people think that you tend to be just a history buff, but I'm actually a big poetry fan. Robert Frost, really love poetry about nature, things like that. So that's kind of what I do, and if I ever get really stressed out, I just sit around, read a little bit of poetry.
I've heard it's a very de-stressing activity.
Oh, it's nice. That and classical music, just right.
So is there anything else you want to say?
I just want to say thank you to all the students at Davis County. The semester's been awesome. The administration's awesome here, and it's been a pleasure to work with the best social studies department in the state of Kentucky.
All right. Have a great day. Thank you for your time.
I appreciate it.
Attention juniors, the 2020 Governor Scholar application is now available at gsp.ky.gov. GSP is a free 5-week summer program where students join others from across the state on one of three college campuses, Century College, Morehead State, or Bellarmine. The program is highly competitive and students are selected by a committee to move on to the state level. After completion of the program, there is a potential for scholarship opportunities available to students. Applications are due to Ms. Leisner and guidance by the end of the day on December 2nd. Please stop by guidance for more information.
Attention students, the Governor's School for the Arts is a free 3-week summer program for students interested in artistic discipline. In artistic discipline, architecture and design, creative writing, dance, drama, instrumental music, musical theater, new media, visual art, and vocal music. During the program, students will grow in their artistic talent while also experiencing hands-on workshops, lectures, and field trips. There is the potential for scholarship opportunities available upon completing the program. Applications are available online and are due January 10th. Feel free to stop into guidance for assistance.
Attention JCL members. JCL dues are due at the end of the month. See Ms. Shafisi in room 201 for details. Stay classy, DC.